Hey guys, Tony Maritato here. So I want to talk about the 7 reasons why you need to create your first digital course like yesterday. So if you've been following any of my content, I've got a whole bunch of videos on the YouTube channel talking about digital courses, talking about different platforms, hosting, all of it. You can do this stuff super easy, but let's talk about why it's so important, why I'm so passionate about it, because I think that you might not necessarily know how powerful this can be. So number one, we want to create a digital course so we stop saying the same things 50,000 times, right? How many times does a patient come to your physical therapy clinic and ask you if they should use heat or ice? How many times does a patient come to you and say, should I do machines or free weights? There are certain questions that are universal. How many times does a patient with spinal stenosis say, I can push a grocery cart all day long through the supermarket, but I can't walk unsupported for 5 minutes. Why is that? These are questions we've been answering every single day in the clinic. Now, we have that opportunity to record our answer, document our answer, get it onto a digital platform, and then make it available to people that you might not ever get to meet or work with or know, but it's information that is universal and applicable to everybody out there with the same complaint, the same question, the same problems. So it is the best thing we have to cloning ourselves, is creating a digital course. Number two, plant your first seed in the new economy, right? I love farming and I love hunting. Hunting is when you go out and you find that perfect client and you develop a plan of care, a relationship, and you sell that client. Planting seeds is farming. Farming is, I create a digital course answering the 10 most common questions related to spinal stenosis. I create a digital course teaching patients how to create their own ice packs using alcohol and water. Like, there are so many mini, micro, tiny little courses that you could be selling for $10 a pop. Those are seeds you're planting out there in the community. And maybe one of them grows into a mighty oak tree. Maybe none of them do, but the idea is that it takes little to no effort. You just start planting and see what grows. But it's something that absolutely could potentially give you the return on your investment that is in order of magnitude greater than you can imagine. Number three, leverage the power of compound interest, right? When I treat a patient, I get paid for that hour. That hour of my life is gone. I get paid a flat rate. I'm never gonna get paid for that hour ever again. But if I can create a digital course, if I can spend an hour creating content or 4 hours or 10 hours, that's something that will continue to put money in my bank account. The same digital course I created a year ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago, depending on the topic, is probably just as relevant today. Human backs, human spines, response to pain doesn't change all that much. So once you create an evergreen piece of content, it stays evergreen and continues to pay. It's the closest thing to compound interest we have in our profession. It pays you not to work. Okay, number four, it's never been easier. Creating digital content, hosting platforms, like there is a ridiculous amount of opportunity out there. I love Thinkific. I'm gonna put an affiliate link to Thinkific down in the description of this video. But I also do email paid courses. I do Udemy. There are so many different ways. I have a YouTube channel dedicated to building this kind of content, right? There are so many ways for you to create and sell. Text messaging. I love text messaging. I have memberships where a client can pay to access me through text and I can deliver updates and programming through that. There's apps, obviously. There's so many ways to do it. The idea is that there's never been more opportunity than there is right now. But the problem is, I think, because there's so much opportunity, therapists tend to get frozen and don't totally know what they should be focusing on. So just get out there and start doing it. The next one is, use it to build your personal brand. We live in a different economy. If you would have asked me 20 years ago what you should name your business, I would never tell you to name it anything related to your personal name. I would never tell you to be the spokesperson for your business, because all that did back then was tie you down. It was the golden handcuffs that made it so that every patient wanted to see you and only you. We don't live in that economy anymore. Every piece of digital content I create is me, but when clients come to my clinic, they see my team, they see my staff. Building a personal brand today is very different than building a personal brand 20 years ago. I would say digital courses, little content like that, are one of the best ways for you to establish yourself as an expert, to build your brand, and to start creating a community around the message and the solution that you provide. The next reason is to use it as a way to fund your projects. If I want to do something, I almost never do something until I have a stream of income that pays for that project, right? So if I want to start a new group or I want to experiment with something, I'll put out a digital course with the specific intention that revenue coming from that course will pay for the project, whatever the project may be. Even if I want to buy a piece of equipment, I will put out a digital course using that piece of equipment, explaining that piece of equipment. I'll find sponsors to pay for those videos, and that will be the money that I use to buy the equipment that I want creating that course. It's so crazy and bizarre, but it totally works. And then finally, use your digital courses to establish proof of concept. I see so many clinicians just put heart and soul into creating something before they know that anybody will ever buy it. A $10 digital product, digital course is so inexpensive, such a low barrier to entry. Anybody who has a cell phone, who has the technology to hear about your digital course, has the money in their pocket to buy it. And if you can't even sell your concept at a $10 price point, I wouldn't invest any more time into it, you know? So what I typically do is I pitch the idea. I get people who put cash in my hand before I ever create the main product that I'm trying to sell. And a great in between is I create a little primer, a little easy, low barrier to entry digital course that they can buy. That gets them excited. They then move into my next higher ticket product. I wouldn't call it a value ladder, but you can look at it in that respect. But the idea is that even if it's just a dollar, I will not put my time and effort into something that nobody wants. And the best way for me to confirm is, will you pull out your wallet and put a dollar in my hand? If you will, I will create the $50 product, the $100 product, the $1,000 product. But if I can't even get a dollar, no chance I'm gonna put time and effort into doing something that I think might be worth $1,000, because there's no proof of concept. So those are my seven reasons right now today, the beginning of 2022, why you need to get started creating your first digital product. And if you have created your digital product, I'd love to hear about it. Share a link down in the comments to your digital product so we can see what other clinicians are doing. And I'll do the same. I'll be the first one to post my digital comment, the Zero to Paid Medicare Billing course. Other than that, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next video.